Fernando Fernandez, WBO Junior Featherweight Championship. We'll send you out to Denver, Colorado, where Tim Ryan and Gil Clancy are standing by right after this message and a word from your local station.
Defeated Marco Antonio Barrera enters the ring as one of the world's best fighters. Already popular in Mexico, the soft-spoken champion makes his network television debut in America today. His past opponents already know him well through close encounters with his gloves. Center in Denver, Colorado for the WBO World Junior Featherweight Championship. The sensational Marco Antonio Barrera of Mexico and Orlando Fernandez, the veteran from Puerto Rico. Hi, everybody. I'm Tim Ryan here at ringside, and this crowd, a capacity crowd, is really ready to see a young man perhaps many of you haven't seen on American television, the 22-year-old WBO champion Marco Antonio Barrera. He can punch. He is 41-0 with 29 knockouts and already rated among the very big names in boxing by the likes of Ring Magazine. And I am joined by Gil Clancy, as usual, at ringside. Gil, we've had the chance to watch this young champion in action. I know you think he deserves that ranking.
Tim, I think he certainly does. Great punch. It can get you out with either hand. A great finisher. His best punch is that debilitating left hook to the body that he sets everybody up with. He throws that left hook underneath better than anybody I've ever seen. There it is now. He didn't set the guy up with it. He knocked him out with it. And here you see him against Kennedy McKinney. I mentioned he's a great finisher. Watch this action, Tim. You talk about a finisher. There's a guy that can get you out of there, and he's in with a tough guy in Kennedy McKinney.
Marco Antonio Barrera, exceptionally good. This is a challenge by a former WBO champion, a guy we had here on CBS in a fight he lost against Junior Jones. We thought he won it.
Well, he certainly did, Tim. You have to remember, Junior Jones was at the top of his game then. People said he was the best puncher in boxing. He didn't bother Orlando Fernandez. Fernandez went the distance, landed Jones with a lot of those sneaky right hands, and we thought he won the decision.
Orlando Fernandez has never been stopped. He held his title before Barrera did. He knows that this is his last shot at age 33. As this crowd really pumped up to watch Fernandez, 32 years of age, at 41-0, Fernandez 33, Barrera slightly taller, and he came in at 121.5, Fernandez right at the limit of 122. Slight reach advantage for Barrera. The WBA rules, BO rules, there are no, so there is no standing eight count. Three knockdowns in a round will end the fight. The count continues after the bell, except in the final round. And for the ring introductions, let's go to Jimmy Lennon Jr.
Ladies and gentlemen, a very good afternoon to you, and we welcome you to the Mammoth Event Center here in the beautiful Colorado. Featured attraction of the afternoon here on the CBS Sports Show Boxing Series. Today brought to you by Forum Boxing Incorporated in association with Joe Cutillac International Events. This coming your way is sanctioned by the World Boxing Organization. The President Francisco Valcarcel, Supervisor Boxing Legend Jose Torres. Introducing to you the judges scoring this bout from ringside. From the Dominican Republic, Juan Baez. From Albuquerque, New Mexico, Jim Boggio. From Houston, Texas, Robert Gonzalez. And our referee in charge of this bout from the east side of LA, Vince Delgado. All right, fans, here we go with the main event of the afternoon. 12 rounds of boxing for the WBO Junior Featherweight Championship of the World. Introducing first the challenger on my right, fighting out of the red corner. Wearing black trunks with gold trim, he weighed in at 122 pounds even. His record includes 22 wins, 7 losses, with 13 wins coming by way of knockout. From Yabucoa, Puerto Rico, here is the former WBO Junior Featherweight World Champion, currently ranked the number 9 one contender, introducing Orlando Cholo Fernandez. And his opponent across the ring, the defending world champion on my left, fighting out of the blue corner, wearing blue trunks with white trim. He weighed in at 121.5 pounds. He is unbeaten in his campaign in the ring with 41 wins, no losses, 29 wins coming by way of knockout. From Mexico City, Distrito Federal, Mexico, today making the seventh defense of his title, here is the undefeated WBO Junior Featherweight Champion of the World, known as the Baby-Faced Assassin, Marco Antonio Barrera. Once again, a referee in charge, Vince Delgado, to give instructions.
Okay, you get your instructions in the dressing room. Good luck, and shake hands.
There's Orlando Fernandez, a smile at the accolades vocally given to Barrera. There is a large Mexican population in Denver, and they are clearly favoring the champion. And Fernandez from Puerto Rico, while they share the language, does not have the same enthusiasm from the crowd here today. Barrera in blue, Fernandez in black and gold. Round one scheduled for 12. You may note the tapia on the belt of Barrera's trunks. That is for his mother, Rosa Maria Tapia, and she is here at the fight along with his dad. Not to be confused with the excellent boxer from Albuquerque, Johnny Tapia, just the same name.
Tim, Orlando Fernandez has a habit of leading with that right hand. He's very tricky the way he does it. Moves his weight over to the left. You think he's going to throw the left hook. He throws lead right hands. But if Barrera ever catches him coming in, when he's throwing that lead right hand, the way Barrera punches, it's going to be lights out.
And we did see that, a very effective punch, and they lost to Junior Jones, a fight we said we thought that Fernandez deserved the decision in. Jones then a recent former world champion, and it was a great performance by Fernandez. Fernandez in excellent condition, trains well all the time, a real professional, every sense of the term.
And Tim, he says he's used to fighting in the other guy's hometown. He's been all over the world, so he's used to the cheers for the other guy, and he hopes he gets an equal break on a decision if he does win the fight.
His best win against Nelson Rodriguez. He defeated Valerio Natti to win the WBO title in May of 1990, then lost over 12 rounds to Jesse Benavidez in May of 91. Two-year-old champion in blue, very relaxed. Good shot, caught. Fernandez leaning, bringing the right from underneath. Both of them holding and hitting, and that got Barrera angry, as you can see. Vince Delgado warns them both.
And you see Fernandez is moving to his right, Tim. That's not a normal move. An orthodox fighter. Neil Barrera with a pretty good right hand then too. And watch Fernandez walk over to his right instead of sliding to his left and following a jab the way most fighters do. That can take a little bit of the punching power away.
Good right hand by Barrera. Final seconds of round one. Tim Ryan and Gil Clancy ready for round two, live on the CBS Sports Show, scheduled for 12. The WBO Junior Featherweight Championship at 122. Barrera in blue, the champion. Fernandez in black, the challenger. Ranked number 9 by the WBO.
Very, very slow getting out of Fernandez's corner. Vince Delgado had to hold the fighters up while they get out of the ring.
Crowd chanting early here, Mexico, Mexico for Barrera. He is a native and still lives in Mexico City. As we commented, good sized Mexican population here in Denver. I have to support him. And Fernandez scoring to the body and got an uppercut inside there with Barrera resting against the ropes. Pressure from Fernandez. This is what he likes to do.
Barrera was trying to escape, but Fernandez wouldn't allow him to. And again, you see Fernandez with that right hand lead, Tim. Does it time and time again.
Slow, step back.
Time, Barrera timed it and just nailed him with a pretty solid punch.
Barrera likes to think of himself as a thinker in the ring, like one of his idols, Salvador Sanchez. Great Mexican champion who was indeed a very intelligent boxer in addition to being a big puncher. Barrera had ambitions of going to law school until his fistic career got to be such a good one and the money started coming in.
Vince Delgado was allowing him to fight on the inside. So far it's been all Fernandez on the inside. There goes Barrera with that flashing left hook to the body.
And a good short left uppercut to start his move off the ropes.
More solid punches by Barrera. I think he shook Fernandez with that one right hand, Tim.
Fernandez has never been stopped in his career.
Never been down.
29 fights.
Again, you see him with that right hand lead, Tim. That's very, very dangerous. And eventually, Barrera's going to get wise to that move.
Under 30 seconds, we go in round two of the scheduled 12-round title bout. Coming to the end of round number two. We are back live in Denver on the CBS Sports Show. Tim Ryan with Gil Clancy watching the WBO Junior Featherweight Championship. The champion in blue is Marco Antonio Barrera of Mexico. The challenger, ranked number 9 by the WBO, is Orlando Fernandez in black.
Tim, both fighters are moving to their right. Again, it's an unusual move, and it's difficult. Now Barrera is trying to cut the ring or trying to move over.
Barrera showing that jab.
Short with most of those jabs, though, Tim.
Yes, he was. Technically very sound delivering his punches, but Fernandez an elusive target to the jab so far.
I'm waiting to see what happens there when Barrera finally lands that left hook to the body. Favorite punch. He hasn't had a chance. I guess it's the way Fernandez is moving and is tying up that left hook.
In the third round, scheduled for 12, Vince Delgado can talk to both of these boxers in his native Spanish as well. Oh, big shots there from Barrera. That backed up Fernandez. A combination.
It goes a little low, Tim. Right on the south of the border.
One low and then one up. Fernandez just keeps boring back in. And there's a Barrera giving him a shot. Gets a warning. It was on the break. He was complaining about being held and hit behind the head.
Tim, I'd like to count how many times so far in this fight Fernandez lived with that right hand. There it is again. Just keeps leading with right hand. Forgets all about a jab.
Rough, tough action here in the third round. Barrera banging to the body. A little redness under the left eye of Fernandez. Two good body shots from Fernandez and a left to the head of Barrera. Into the final minute of round three.
There it is again.
There's the big left hook. That stopped Fernandez in his tracks. There's a left and a right. Barrera sensing him hurt.
And we know what a finisher he is, Tim. But again, he's in with a strong guy. Guy's never been down. Knows how to kill the clock when he's in trouble.
Big left hook of the body stopped him right in his tracks.
Again, he got caught leading with that right hand.
Body shot, uppercut from Barrera, right hand behind it. Final seconds of an action-packed round three. Orlando Fernandez took quite a shot to the body, and then Barrera tried to finish him off, but the well-conditioned Fernandez survived that. We're into round four. Barrera in blue, Fernandez in black.
Heads were pretty busy in there with both fighters.
Body blows and her left hand up to the chin of Fernandez.
Tim, he can really take a punch, Fernandez. That's the kind of punch that would put just about any other fighter down on the deck. No wonder he's never been down in a fight. Solid left hook.
33-year-old from Yabucoa, Puerto Rico, was actually born in Brooklyn of Puerto Rican parents and moved back to Puerto Rico. He was on the Puerto Rican Olympic team in 1984. He's got family around this country who have immigrated to the U.S. and have stayed here in various cities. Barrera with his immediate family here, his mom and dad.
Barrera is very, very relaxed on that inside. There's that left hook to the body. Watch how relaxed Barrera is on the inside there. He said he's a thinking fighter. He certainly is.
Fernandez trying to stay close to him, and there's a good move by Barrera, spinning Fernandez around, banging to the body. So relaxed, Barrera. Backing away to give himself some more punching range. Fernandez wants to be right on his chest.
Little cute move by Barrera that time.
Right hand by Fernandez, by Barrera, pardon me, a good one. Solid left jab, snap back the head of Fernandez.
Fernandez is starting to show angry marks underneath that right eye.
See Fernandez trying to work his way in with a hop step there, but good defense by Barrera, covering up on the ropes. Fernandez banging outside the arms, now brings the uppercut in and lands that.
Fernandez using that elbow pretty good on the inside too, Tim. You watch that elbow.
Uppercut by Barrera. Steps out and he wobbled Fernandez that time. Fernandez covering up, punching back. Barrera takes another rest. Fernandez lands two uppercuts. Barrera thought he had him going down. The bell sounds ending round four. What a fight.
Tim, Fernandez may not be the best fighter I've ever seen, but I think he's the toughest. I've never seen a guy take punishment like that and then fire back the way he did.
Took two big shots and knocked him off balance. Take a look at that from round four. Oh, started with that uppercut.
And then that left hook to the ribs against him.
And two big head shots and the finish with the left hand. Now it looked like Delgado, the referee, thought that Fernandez was going down. And you see him step in stopping Barrera, which angered him, of course. But Fernandez just refused to go down, which is his style.
Well, what was he going to do, hit him in the back? I thought the referee did a good job.
Nonetheless, he never did go down. So we await round five, and Fernandez looking a little bit used up there after that action in round four, but he's a warrior, never been stopped.
Watch your head.
We have Barrera ahead three rounds with one even going into this fifth round. and they haven't been easy for him. Now using the jab effectively to open the fifth. Hernandez bowling his way in again.
Hold it. Step back.
That's the way Hernandez has to fight. Has to go down the inside and use everything he's got, including the elbows.
Great right hand by Barrera. Hernandez fires back.
All right, hold it. Step back.
I'm sure that just about everybody that Barrera has hit with the punches he's hit Hernandez with has gone out. He's got to say to himself, this has got to be some tough guy. What do I have to do to get him out of there?
Barrera's best wins against Frankie Toledo, Eddie Croft, and of course Kennedy McKinney. Had him down five times. McKinney knocked him down once before Barrera prevailed. Big left hand from Barrera. Hernandez gamely bores back in, simply doesn't have the same firepower. Drives him into the ropes with a left and a right. Overhand right landed by Hernandez.
He's landing some punches, Tim.
Yes,
he's still in there.
Barrera resting on the ropes and Hernandez making him pay here. Trying that overhand right again, getting it in.
And Barrera that time had a hold.
From Barrera that straightened up Hernandez. Toe to toe they go.
Both of these fighters, Tim, have to be in excellent condition. You have to remember, mile high, and both of them are setting a furious pace.
Another good combination, ending with a right hand from the champion Barrera. Hernandez shrugs that off. Of course, Barrera lives at altitude in Mexico City. Shouldn't bother him. Hernandez asked about it since he's from sea level in Puerto Rico, that he's been up high a lot of times in many other fights in other places. Final seconds, round five. Orlando Hernandez and the champion Barrera in blue. The WBO Junior Featherweight Championship at 122 pounds. Barrera and Hernandez going toe-to-toe through most of the fifth. Tremendous action on this, our final boxing show of the CBS Sports Show boxing season. And we've got a dandy to finish it up. No matter what the outcome now, they've put in five exciting rounds. Barrera, the 22-year-old champion, unbeaten with 41 wins and no defeats. Motorcycle fans who are hoping maybe that race would get started into Des Moines, Illinois. It is now an official rainout. Bad weather there on making the track unrideable in Illinois. So unfortunately that one will not be seen now today on the CBS Sports Show.
Tim Barrera has changed his strategy slightly. Now he's trying to move a little more, work behind that left jab. He knows he's in with a strong guy. Doesn't want to get into a slugfest despite the fact that he's the better puncher. Sometimes it's who's the better catcher. Not pitching.
Hernandez keeps coming forward, keeps trying to make something happen. Knows he has to be inside. And he's backed up again by Barrera with a combination. And a big left hook. Hernandez fires back from the ropes, trying to escape, and he does.
And he's pulling Barrera on. What a tough guy, Tim.
And the Mexican crowd here in Denver favoring the champion from Mexico City. Non-stop action in this one, scheduled for 12.
You can see the way Hernandez takes that weight, leads to the left, and then slips that right hand lead in time and time again to get back on the inside. He doesn't move in behind the jab, moves in behind right hands 90% of the time.
Into the final minute of round six, Hernandez shrugging off the referee after a clinch, trying to get right back in.
There's the right hand lead again.
Hold it.
Low blow by Barrera. Hernandez has been the busier boxer of the two here on the sixth. But the bigger punches, again, a damaging right hand. Rocks Hernandez, sending him back to the ropes.
And Barrera has real heavy hands. No matter what he hits you with, he hurts you. Good right hand, left hook by Barrera. But Hernandez, excuse me.
Look at Hernandez, keep throwing punches in there. Not with the same impact, but he's landing them. Barrera fires back. Final seconds of the sixth round. Uppercut scored, a right hand, and Hernandez almost goes down. They are counting a knockdown. Count will continue after the bell, but he's up, and that's the end of round number six. In the corner of Hernandez.
Jim, sometimes a fight is a little too game for his own good. I start really starting to be concerned about Hernandez's condition.
Let's see the knockdown. It was even a somewhat questionable one. Let's see if his glove hits
his
canvas.
His glove touched the canvas.
Right there, it did. Okay, so Vince Delgado sees that. Starts the count, which continued after the bell, but he was already up.
But again, Tim, they should start checking Fernandez's condition. He's taking some terrible punishment.
Rounds five and six, particularly, Barrera started to connect more heavily and more cleanly, although in the first part of round number six, Hernandez actually was a busier guy, landing more punches, but the big, heavy shots were from Barrera, the champion.
That's what makes it so difficult, Tim. Again, sometimes fighters are too game for their own good.
33-year-old Orlando Hernandez, and there's the young champion with another big right hand.
Well, you see, he's setting him up with the jab nuts, and now he's starting to move and box. And then you see that left jab, he's...
Much more difficult for Hernandez to get inside with that jab coming in his face.
Put your head!
When he is on the inside, though, Tim, he's a tough guy in there. He's got the head going, both hands going, and the elbow going.
Well, those are point-scoring punches. Barrera will rest for a bit and then do this. Explode out. And there's a big left hand driving Hernandez into the ropes. Hernandez refusing to go down. Barrera pours it on. And that's it. Vince Delgado says that's enough. Antonio Barrera goes to 42-0, his 30th knockout. The first time Orlando Hernandez has been stopped in his 29 fight, make it 30 fight career. And the young champion looks almost as fresh now as he did at the start.
Here we see the action, Tim. Barrera's on the ropes. He flashes out the way he had done so often in the fight. Nailed him with that left hook underneath to start everything. Now he has a little bit of trouble. Oh, but look at that left hook, Tim. And he still didn't go down. And another left hook.
Hernandez gamely trying to stay on his feet, but there's a straight right. And finally, Delgado wisely stepping into the action, and bravely, we might add, with Barrera throwing punches, said that's enough punishment for this game challenger, Orlando Hernandez.
Well, we mentioned what a great finisher Barrera was. Once he gets you hurt, Tim, there's no escaping. He almost knocked out Delgado with that right hand.
One more right hand right there, and that's the one that brought Delgado in. And so Barrera, to the delight of this largely pro Barrera crowd, has defended his title and moved to 42-0 unbeaten with 30 knockouts. And we'll be back to talk to the champion in a moment. Well, for the official result of this exciting fight, let's go to ring announcer Jimmy Lennon Jr.
Ladies and gentlemen, we have the time. 1 minute, 3 seconds of round number seven. Our referee in charge, Vince Delgado, stops the contest. He's the winner by way of technical knockout. Still undefeated, still WBO Junior Featherweight Champion of the World, the baby-faced assassin, Marco Antonio Barrera.
Marco. Now we've got the champion, and we've also got the challenger, Orlando Fernandez. First time he was ever stopped. Can we ask Orlando, first of all, for your feeling about this young guy? He's just 22 years of age. What are your impressions?
He's a very good, talented young man. He knows how to fight. He knows how to throw his upper, turn to his side. And he's very good. He's talented.
It was another game effort by you, Orlando. I think this time you're a little bit outgunned. What about your thoughts now at age 33?
I'm going to think about it. But actually, that's why I could have kept on going. They stopped the fight, but I could have kept on going.
All right. Well, we know you would have kept on going, Orlando. And congratulations for giving us a terrific fight.
I never finished on the floor. So at least, you know, I'm standing up.
That's right. You sure are. Well, let's talk to the champion. Congratulations, Orlando. You're more than welcome. You're a great fighter. Marco Antonio Barrera, now America knows you very well with his great performance here this afternoon against a very, very difficult fighter. You seem so confident at such a young age.
When I fight in L.A., I think so that I fight in my home because all the people, the mundo hispana that live here in the United States, he like me boxeo and he like fight here in L.A.
Well, you seem very confident here in front of a crowd that was largely your crowd here in Denver. Many Mexicans came to see you here.
Yes, all the people, Mexican people that come here and watch my fight, I think so I do the best for this fight.
Well, your English is terrific. I think it's even improved in the last 24 hours. You've been practicing.
Well, I have four Mondays studying in school, but maybe for the next fight I will talk more English.
Who would you like to have for the next fight?
Well, my next fight, I think so, I don't know exactly, but maybe it's Jesse Magaña, I don't know. Good fighter, I like fight. I don't know what fight with me.
Whoever is out there, you're ready to fight. Is that correct?
It's equal. It's equal for me. I fight anywhere.
Okay. Congratulations to you. Terrific show, Marco Antonio Barrera. We've got more boxing ahead. Kevin Kelly and Derek Gaynor, a fight that took place not so long ago. It was action-packed. It's coming up after this.